Now that we have the Yuja software downloaded and installed on this computer, we can change some of our settings to make sure that we're capturing the way we want. Now you can see here that it is showing the video source, which is my built-in web camera. If you're seeing me a little bit kung fu, like my lip sync is out of sync, it's because I'm recording this tutorial video at the same time as I'm showing you a video capture software. And so there's a little bit of an issue there, but it wouldn't happen with your videos that you create in Yuja. This is also showing my screen, my desktop, and it's showing my microphone source that it is actually picking up sound because it's moving. Now, as long as those three things are all good, you should be good to go, but I wanted to go over some settings with you. Over here, you can see your input devices and what is showing. So for each one of these, you can click on them and choose whether to turn them on or off. So I want the microphone on and the videos on. I also wanted to show you that I have two microphones. I actually have a built-in microphone and a Yeti stereo microphone. Normally, I would switch it to the Yeti stereo microphone, but because I'm using it for my tutorial video, I can't. So just know that if you have two microphones, one internal and one that you've plugged in, you might need to come in here and pick the one that works best. Now for your screen, a lot of people have asked, what if I want to show a secondary screen? Like I know a lot of us have double displays. So this is where you can choose what display you want to actually record with. And then you can also choose to capture a selected area, so a specific part of your screen. All right, the other options are to go live with this video and to change your profile, which you can play with as you see fit. Now in settings up here, I generally come up here and I don't want it to start on startup for me, so I click no. And I don't want it to hide the mini video action bar. That's like a tiny little bar where you can pause and stop and start the video. So I'd like to see that every time I record a video. And then let's see, I do want it to keep recordings for 7 days, but if you wanted to keep it for longer, just in case, you can increase that. Now it's important to know your hotkeys if you're a keyboard shortcut person. So I like to pause it all the time. For a Mac, this means Shift Command P. If you're on a PC, it probably says the word like Shift Control P. So make sure you check that out and put a little sticky note so you can reference it quickly while you're recording. Then for your screen capture, it's going to ask you what's the frame rate. So right now it says 15. That's going to create a pretty small file size. If it's for some reason your video is a little bit low quality or it feels very choppy, I usually take mine up to like 24, but that might be too big of a file for you. So you're going to have to play with some of these settings. But for me, I just choose 24. And this is the like biggest version of standard definition video is 1280 by 720. And I like to do high definition videos, which is 1920 by 1080 is the very first level of high definition. This is super high definition, but 1920 by 1080 is going to find that good balance of quality versus file size. But here's where you can also change the file size, whether it's big or small. So I'm not really sure. You're going to have to talk to Troy to see Troy or the D2L administrator, if for some reason you're watching this like years in the future and Troy isn't there, you're going to have to talk to them about whether or not you can do a bigger file size. So again, I would just kind of mess around with this. Large should be fine for file size, in my opinion. And then I like to do high video quality, but that's because mine is really dependent on people seeing the software that I'm using and the artwork that we're creating in it. So for you, you might not need it to be very high quality. So again, it's just going testing it. I would definitely recommend creating a couple different test videos just to see what settings work, and then go from there. So I'll go ahead and hit save. And it's going to give me a warning. Do I really want to do this? Because it's different than recommended settings. And I'm going to click yes for me. Again, you should probably just create a test video with the recommended settings and see if it works for you. And if for some reason it needs to be higher quality or the file size is too big or whatever the case may be, now you know where to change it in the settings. So in the next video, we're going to actually create our test video and see what we can do with that.